In today's video, we're going to be talking about how to get rid of visceral fat. Visceral fat is a type of fat that is stored within the abdominal cavity and is one of the key indicators of metabolic syndrome and insulin resistance. This type of fat is particularly concerning because it surrounds vital organs, including our liver, our stomach, and our intestines. Visceral fat cells produce inflammatory markers, which lead to chronic inflammation and eventually chronic diseases such as heart disease. Reducing visceral fat can significantly reduce your disease risk while improving your health and improving your overall quality of life. So in today's video, I'm going to give you 5 actionable steps you can take to start reducing visceral fat today. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high fat, nutrient dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Feel free to share and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook where I share new posts every single day. Before we begin, I want to thank Squarespace for sponsoring today's video. For everything from websites and online stores to marketing tools and analytics, Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to build a beautiful website and run your business. Head to squarespace.com/healthcoachkate to start your free trial today. We're going to start off today talking about what visceral fat is and why it is particularly dangerous, and then we will get into the 5 steps you can take to reduce it. Visceral versus subcutaneous fat. As I said at the start of this video, visceral fat is a type of fat that is stored in our abdominal cavity surrounding our organs. The other type of fat is subcutaneous fat, which is stored just beneath our skin in various areas around our body. Subcutaneous fat is considered to be good fat because it is less harmful than visceral fat. This is your body's stored energy supply, so having some subcutaneous fat is totally normal and totally healthy. Any fat you can pinch on your body is subcutaneous fat. Visceral fat is hard, and large amounts will result in a protruding belly, but you can still have visceral fat even if you cannot see it. Now, like subcutaneous fat, some visceral fat is normal and healthy, but when you have an excess of it, this is when it starts to become a problem. Excess visceral fat can be caused by a few different factors, which we will talk about more as we go through this video. But now let's get into the 5 steps you can take to reduce visceral fat, and make sure to stick around until the end, because the last one you might not expect. Number 1, reduce fructose. Fructose is a type of simple sugar that makes up 50% of table sugar and is also found naturally in fruit. Fructose has to be processed by the liver in order to be used, whereas with glucose, it doesn't, and it can be used for energy immediately. Excess fructose tends to get stored as visceral fat, whereas excess glucose tends to get stored as subcutaneous fat. In a study done on 41 children, fructose was replaced with starch in the diet, providing the same amount of calories. In just 10 days, visceral fat reduced by over 10%. The main sources of fructose in modern day diets are from sugar-sweetened beverages and fruit juice. These drinks allow us to consume massive amounts of fructose that we wouldn't be able to consume from whole food sources such as fruit. The average American consumes 85 to 100 grams of fructose every single day. This is equivalent to 25 teaspoons of sugar. Now, of course, pop is a huge problem here. A bottle of Coke has over 35 grams of fructose, but fruit juice is also a concern. 1 cup of orange juice has 14 grams of fructose, whereas 1 orange in whole food form contains only 6 grams. Now, some people choose to decrease their fruit intake entirely and only stick to low sugar fruit, but I don't think that is necessary for everyone. If you can at least cut out pop and fruit juice, this will significantly reduce your fructose intake and in turn lead to a reduction in visceral fat. Number 2, increase stearic acid. Stearic acid is a type of saturated fat that has been highly associated with fat loss and specifically visceral fat loss. Stearic acid is found in the fat of meat. It is found in animal fat used for cooking, such as tallow and butter, and also in some fatty plant foods, such as cacao butter. In 1 study done in mice, where the mice were fed a diet enriched with either stearic acid, which is saturated fat, linoleic acid, which is polyunsaturated fat, or oleic acid, which is monounsaturated fat, They didn't see much difference in the total body weight between groups at the end of the study. However, the stearic acid group saw a 70% reduction in visceral fat and an increase in lean body mass when compared to the other groups. This study is, of course, done in mice and not humans, so we have to take it with a grain of salt, but it's very interesting nonetheless. Swapping your cooking oil for one that is high in stearic acid, such as tallow or butter, can help to boost your stearic acid intake. Number three, improve insulin sensitivity. If you've been watching my videos over the last several months, I have been talking about insulin resistance a lot, and it is particularly relevant to today's topic. Insulin resistance is the driving force behind visceral fat in a lot of cases. It occurs when our bodies stop responding to insulin in the correct way due to an overproduction of it. When you're insulin resistant, fat gets stored in places that it usually wouldn't, such as around our organs in our abdomen. If you can reduce your insulin resistance and improve your insulin sensitivity, this will help to prevent and reduce visceral fat. The best strategies to improve insulin resistance are low-carb diets and intermittent fasting. Both of these stimulate insulin only minimally, or in the case of fasting, not at all, which is what you want when you are trying to reverse insulin resistance. I have a whole playlist on insulin resistance, which has videos on how to know if you're insulin resistant and how to reverse it, that you can check out afterwards if you want to know more. Number four, reduce alcohol intake. Visceral fat is also highly associated with excess alcohol consumption. Like fructose, alcohol has to be processed by our liver, and excess consumption can lead to more fat being stored in the abdomen. In one study done on 8,000 men, they found that those who drank more alcohol also had the largest waist circumference. And I think a lot of people know that excess alcohol consumption has this effect, as we often refer to this fat accumulation as a beer belly. Cutting back on your alcohol consumption can help to reduce visceral fat. Number five, reduce stress. And finally, we're going to talk about the role stress plays in visceral fat. When we are stressed, our bodies produce more cortisol, which is the stress hormone. And this has been shown to increase the amount of fat stored in the abdomen. Reducing stress is, of course, easier said than done. Periodic stress is normal and even beneficial, but when we are chronically stressed, it might be time to take a step back and evaluate how you can reduce your stress load. Now, before we wrap up, I'm going to tell you about today's sponsor, Squarespace. Now, it is thanks to companies like Squarespace that I am able to spend more time researching and creating my videos and offering them for free to you. So if you are looking for a platform to build a website or run your business, consider Squarespace. Not only does Squarespace allow you to build and run your website through their platform, they also allow you to create an email list, schedule meetings and clients, run an online store, accept payments, and more. Their all-in-one platform is easy to use, and you never have to upgrade or patch anything. Their award-winning customer service team is available 24/7 to answer any questions you may have. To start a free trial, you can head to squarespace.com/healthcoachkate. You don't have to enter your credit card details or anything to start your trial and build your website. And when you love it and decide to launch, you can use code HealthCoachKate to save 10% off your first order. Thank you again to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Anyways, guys, that is all I have for you today. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and leave me a comment down below. Your comments really help to boost engagement, and that means that YouTube will recommend my videos more and they'll be able to reach more people. If you do leave a comment, you're the best. I try to respond to every single one. If you did enjoy this video, you might also enjoy my videos in my insulin resistance playlist, which you can check out here. If you wanna catch up on my most recent upload, you can click right here. And if you wanna check out my keto and carnivore diet coaching programs, you can find them here. Thanks again, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.